He's literally shaking the camera. My dog, by the way. My dog. Are you good? Hi, welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, hi, my name is Vivian and my dog is behind the camera. So if he's shaking, if you guys can hear snoring or anything like that, he's literally behind the camera. Please ignore him. Hopefully he will not make any weird sounds. But yeah, today we're gonna do my April TBR. He just snored. I use the TBR prompt jar. If you guys have watched a few of my TBR videos, y'all should know that. It's just really fun to match a prompt to a book. I use this method all the time and it's really helpful for finding my TBR. So I am gonna do the same thing. This is my TBR jar. My prompts are in little sticks like this because
I find it easier to pick them when they're little sticks like this instead of them being folded, because I feel like when they're folded, it's hard to separate the papers together. So this is really helpful for me.
And we're gonna pick 8 prompts. I do 8 prompts every single month. This month is gonna be the same. I'm actually crunching on time, so I'm gonna get this over with as soon as possible. So I'm gonna pick out my first prompt. This one says 6 and more word title. Oh my gosh, wait a second.
6 or more?
The Wall of Winnipeg and Me. Okay, this one is an option. The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue is another option. A Fate of Wrath and Flame. Okay, actually, you know what? We have a few options here. Okay, we do have a lot of options. I'm gonna pick some of them. I am down to The House in the Cerulean Sea with TJ Klune and The Wall of Winnipeg and Me by Marina Zapata. I want to read this one only because I'm like halfway through the book. Well, not halfway. I'm 82 pages through the book. And this one is more of because it's been on my TBR for a very long time. Basically, with my TBR cart, this middle portion here are high priority books, I would say. Ooh, which one do I want to pick? This has been on my TBR for a while. And I've also put this in like one of my monthly TBRs and I never got into it. You know what? I'm gonna pick The House in the Cerulean Sea with TJ Klune because this has been on my TBR for a very long time. I figure it's time to actually pick this up finally and not like push this off any longer. It's a very easy read. It's less than 400 pages. I should be able to do it. Let's pick this book as my first prompt. Let us pick our second prompt. I'm hoping that I don't pick any repeats. Okay. Color of the spine matches the random color generator. I'm gonna need to get my phone for this prompt. I'm gonna go on Google and just type random color generator. This is the first one that pops up. And you're supposed to just create random colors. Ooh, antique pink. I think I'm just gonna make it pink and not antique pink ever by Jessa Hastings. Actually, this one really matches this. This one like is a perfect match. Or The Summer of Broken Rules, but I do not want to read this. This is more like a summer book. I'm not mad about this because I do want to read Never, and I also have tabs picked out, which is why I really, really want to read it. This is a good option. I've had this on my monthly TBR too, but I did not end up reading it, but now I'm in the mood to actually read this, and it is on my high priority shelf. All I know about this book is that it's a Peter Pan retelling, and I've heard that it's toxic relationships. I think it's a fantasy, but I'm not really too sure. Once again, we're just gonna see how it goes. I'm gonna go into this a little bit blind, and I love Jess Hastings' writing. She writes like a poet. Her writing is beautiful, so I'm excited. Third prompt. What is this? Dual POV. I picked out dual POV. First of all, I have not put this back. Is Witcher and Blackbird dual POV? Sloane, Rowan, yeah. This is dual POV. Funny Feelings, is that dual POV? This is also dual POV, Funny Feelings, Patera, Do It. I read this already. This is the second book to a duology, but I don't remember if this is dual POV or not. Oh, it's multiple POV. Do I wanna put this in or do I wanna put this in? If you guys do not know, I actually have a tiny book club that I have with like 3 of my friends, and this is our book club pick of the month, so picking this is a good idea because I will be reading it. You know what? I'm gonna pick Witcher and Blackbird. I feel like it's a safe option. I'm definitely gonna pick it up. I'm just gonna pick this as my dual POV prompt. Witcher and Blackbird is about 2 serial killers who kill serial killers, like Robin Hood style, and that's all I know. It's friends to lovers as well, so they like meet and then they end up being friends and then they fall in love, I think. I've heard great things, so I do want to read it. That's my third pick. I'm gonna pick out my fourth prompt now.
I'm really crunch on time, you guys.
Okay, cover has the same color scheme as my outfit, and my outfit currently is black top and some beige pants. I don't even get to see the beige pants. Do I find like a beige and black book,
or do I just find a black book?
Can I count this as gold? Oh, I think this one is like the closest that we have because it's black and then there are like hints of gold slash beige that kind of fits my pants. I think this is the closest one that we have. Actually, this fits, but this is the third book of a series that I haven't even started. So, well, this is the closest one we have. So I'm just gonna pick this. A Fate of Wrath and Flame by K.A. Tucker. This is a romanticy, I think. I know there's something to do with gods playing a role in the world. It's about a girl who ends up falling into a different universe, and she is a princess in that universe, waking up in the body of a treacherous elven princess. I love going into these kind of books blind, which is why I don't really like to read the synopsis of these books. So, okay, my dog is scratching his face. Let us pick our fifth prompt. Okay, I picked this one. This says, book published in the month you are in. Things are not looking good, guys. I'm not even gonna try to search more. The Wall of Winnipeg and Me is published in March, so I'm filming this in March, okay? So we're just gonna pick March and we're just gonna do this. Oh, if you guys do not know, this is a football romance. MMC is the football player and the FMC is his assistant. And after 2 years working with him, she decides to quit. And then a few months or a few days later, he ends up going back to her and asking her to become his assistant again. And there's a whole slow burn romance in there. And I've read 82 pages, so I do want to get this done. This is my fifth book pick. I'm gonna pick my sixth prompt now. Heart of a Duology. We Fear the Stars by Hafsa Faisal. The first book is We Hunt the Flame. I read it last month. Well, this month technically, but it's gonna be my March wrap up that I'm gonna be uploading after this video. So I am excited to get into this. This is one of the ones that I really want picked. So I'm excited for this and I love this prompt. So We Hunt the Flame follows Zafira, who is this hunter. And in this world, there's this thing called the Ars, where a part of the island has turned into like black something. And basically if anyone goes inside the Ars, they usually cannot find their way out, they will die. Or if they find their way out, they will go crazy. But Zafira is the only person who can go inside the Ars to hunt for food and come out unscathed. And she's called the Hunter. She pretends to be a guy. There's another character, the MMC. He is the prince of this whole country, the Sultan's son. They end up having to go on a quest. They're on separate teams, but then the MMC will have to kill the FMC after she finds the thing that they're looking for in this quest. And it's so good. Enemies to lovers. Like, I am not kidding you. It is beautiful enemies to lovers because you gotta kill each other, but they don't end up killing each other because they fall in love. Oh, I'm gonna love We Fear the Stars, honestly. So I'm gonna pick this up. This is my sixth prompt. Okay, we're gonna pick our seventh prompt. That was an easy pick. That was freaking easy. What does this say? Book published in 2023, which means it should be published last year, which means I have a lot of options. These two are technically published this year, so I'm not gonna pick that. Oh! Wishing Game was published last year, right? Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was in 2023. I'm gonna pick The Wishing Game by Max Schaffer. Not a hard pick too, because I really want to read this book. This is a lit fic about a teacher aide who really wants to adopt this kid that's in her class. And I've heard great things about this book from a lot of different booktubers and booktalkers. So I really want to read this and I feel like it's gonna be an easy and fun read. It is only 200-ish pages, less than 300, which is great. I feel like with this, I have a very balanced TBR pile because I have fantasies and I have romances and I even have a cozy fantasy. This is great. We're down to our last prompt. I am on schedule. Let's hope this is a good prompt. What is this? Book with a map. So okay, this has to be a fantasy. What is this? Oh, I have paint on my hand. Middle portion is gonna be out because none of these have a map. I know Fabon has a map, but I'm not gonna lie, I'm not in the mood for this. I know what has a map and I'm scared. I'm sorry, I'm not picking this up, I'm sorry. We're not very heavy with the fantasy, so I think it's safe to add a heavier fantasy. I'm kind of thinking of this one. Do I like get out of my comfort zone and pick this? I guess I'm in between these two. Jade War by Vonda Lee or Cassandra Clare's Swordcatcher. I know Jade War has a map because Jade City has a map. These two are very intimidating reads of mine. I really do not want to pick them up. Obviously, I want to get out of my comfort zone. I grow from there, so I will pick either one of these, but I am actually confused. I don't really know which one I want to read. Obviously, it'll be easier to read Jade War considering how I'm already into the world. I'm gonna pick Jade War by Vonda Lee. This is a part of the Greenbone Saga series. This is the second book, and I did read Jade City last year. I've heard great things about this trilogy, but I had a very hard time reading Jade City. It felt like it was really info dumping and lots of information, but obviously because it is a new series, I understand why it had to be very heavy with the information. And also it's a more found family type of fantasy world where there's not much romance, barely any romance actually, like maybe only like 5%. Considering how I'm still remembering the plot of Jade City, I want to read this one. In the Green Bone Saga trilogy, from what I can remember at least, Jade plays a big role in this world, and Jade is used as an enhancement for the powers that they have. But not everyone can use Jade, not everyone can wield Jade. Only certain people with a certain genetic properties can wield Jade. There's a drug that people can use that allows them to wield Jade. That situation goes on, and then there is this rivalry feud thing between two differing clans. Since I do remember the story, I'm just gonna get into Jade War. Things are not gonna get moving if I don't push myself, so this is gonna be our last book. My camera is heating up, so I am going to quickly end this April TBR. Whatever I chose is honestly such an amazing pile, like a really, really good pile of books. So this is my April TBR. We got a very, very good pile. A very balanced pile. We've got some romances, we've got some cozy fantasies, we've got some urban fantasy, we've got some lit fics. I feel like this is a really cohesive pile. I'm impressed. Okay, but that is it for this April TBR. Hopefully you guys enjoyed watching me pick up the prompts and obviously matching the prompts with any of these books. Don't forget to like and subscribe to this video. If you guys want to see more of me, obviously check out my channel. You'll see more videos like this, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.